This is serious. These are collectibles, not toys. Hello, today we got a couple more kind of official LEGO Batman set reveals. These have been kind of floating around in the darker portions of the internet for a while, and they finally showed up on an actual web store. This was not from an official LEGO announcement, but these pictures are good enough and official enough that I can take a look at them. They're not marked confidential or anything like that. First up, we'll get right into them. Two sets in total. The first one is the more interesting, I think, to more viewers on this channel. But the other one is not that bad. We'll get to it. The classic Batman classic TV series Batmobile. I don't have a part count for this just yet, nor do I have a suggested retail price for it. So I'm still waiting for the official announcement of that. And sorry about the low quality image, but that's what we got so far. We'll get better ones pretty soon here. This comes, well, why does this not come with Robin? I want so badly to say this comes with Batman and Robin and the Joker. Good old pink suit Joker. But yeah, it does not come with Robin. So that's definitely something that's missing here. But it's nice to get another one of these as a standalone, especially for older fans, you know, folks who actually remember or who have at least seen the 1966 based TV series. This is intended to be for kids 7 and up, but I don't know how many 7-year-old kids would be familiar with this. And look, they give it a little plaque and a stand that you can rotate, just like they did with the Keaton Batmobile, the smaller version, you know, the minifig scaled version that they did for the not Ultimate Collector Series version as a little add-on, little gift with purchase. Overall, this looks pretty good. There are a lot of things that you can nitpick about this, but it's actually very similar to the version that they did with the 1966 TV, you know, Batman TV series, Batcave set. It's very, very similar in many, many ways, but it has some details that have been changed up. It's nice that you can open this up in the back. It's got three exhausts. I think the previous one had two and they were larger. This is a little bit closer to the source material. And I think I've got another image of it. Yeah, just a plain standalone image. They got the bat phone in there. It's not perfect. I think it should be rotated the other way around. But it's there in more than just spirit, right? I think some of the things about the shaping of the front of it are not ideal, and then the fins are rather thick, you know, especially the red part of the fin there. But overall, I think it's pretty good. I think that this will make a lot of people happy. These do feel very bubble-like, bubble canopy-like, even though they're not entirely round. And I appreciate the arching that was used inside of there, the overly large light up here, which is actually appropriate. I think a lot of things were done nicely here. The most interesting thing about this, most unexpected thing, I'll put it that way, about this is the inclusion of these pieces down here. Because if you go back, you notice right here, no stud shooters. They're not retractable. They don't retract down. They don't just kind of push down in there. You pull them off and then you replace them with these little assemblies, little sub-assemblies, little, you know, miniature basic, most basic sub-assemblies to get this sort of look. So they included four extra pieces in the set to allow you to display this or play with it with the stud shooters removed. What a revolutionary concept that is. How many times have people asked for an alternate, myself included, an alternate when they do stud shooters for weapons, for minifigures? Like, you know, just include one extra piece for each figure that represents something that looks a little bit more like an actual weapon. Well, that's kind of what they've done here for people who don't want to have the stud shooters on top. They've included that. What is that supposed to be? Is that supposed to be like, is that the radio antenna or radar? What, I forget. It's supposed to have like four sides to it, so it's not absolutely ideal, but I get what they were going for. And it's another thing that, of course, you can just remove if you want. Really, really, really too bad that they did not include a Robin with this, though. I know they have to do the versus thing. You know, they've got to have the conflict in a box, but this would have been better as a Batman and Robin set, even without the Joker at all. Some people will appreciate getting this, to be sure. But I think it would have been better to have this just as a gift with purchase or something, as a standalone. This Batman looks pretty cool. Does he actually have black print? I think that's black print and not dual molding for this cowl. So So it's black on blue there. No dual molding for the legs, but yeah, I just think this will make a lot of people happy. Wait, is that Robin right there? Or is that Batman? Oh no, it is Batman. I'm still wanting Robin out of this a little bit too badly. All right, let's look at the other one though. We saw that picture. So this is a 4+ set. So it's for the juniors. So a lot of the collectors are gonna immediately go, "Boo! It's not for me. It's not for adults." But you know what? I actually think this is really good for a number of reasons. Batman versus the Joker, Batmobile Chase, they call it. I think this is really good for a number of reasons. I think this image a little bit better. Maybe a little bit better. Shows you some of the accessories it comes with. Maybe some of these accessories are a little bit too small for the four-year-old crowd to keep track of. You know, some of those things will get lost. But look at these vehicles, right? Before we get to the figures, look at these vehicles. The Batmobile. That is pretty perfect for a one step above Duplo Batmobile, I think. I like the fact that it has a nice long hood to it, a long engine compartment. Sure, you can't open it up. Sure, it's not super detailed, but it's distinct. Even though this is built on one of those basic, large, singular, modular chassis pieces that they've done so many of the 4+ vehicles on, the designer has made it look distinct. It doesn't look like just another junior's car with a different color scheme and one different print on it or something. It looks like a Batmobile. You can pull these, you know, rotate these in and out to represent the little missile shooters on the side. I think that's plenty fine. You don't have to have them actually shoot. These don't, you know, but they're good for the imaginative play. You know, they give you a little physical component to tie into that. You actually move something. You hold on to it, you move it, and then you pretend that now you're shooting. I think that's good. And this totally works as a roofless vehicle, I think. You just put the Batman down on there, and it's convenient and everything. I think that's good. I think it's a good 4+ Batmobile. I personally, as an adult, like the Joker-mobile here even better, just how it looks. You know, it looks a little bit more advanced, a little bit more elevated. But even though it really is a 4+ thing, it doesn't have too many pieces. There's good color blocking here. I think this is this not, I'm trying to think, did SpongeBob have one of these? This might be the first time, I think this is the first time I can remember seeing this piece, this old 1920s car passenger compartment piece in the lime green color there. I might be mistaken on that, but I don't think I've seen it in that color before. The engine is done really simply, but it looks good. Where the grill is, where the radiator is, how low this is, like, this looks nice. And then you got just the basic lobber on the back of it, a little catapult there. This, I guess, is supposed to represent an ATM. Looks more like a safe to me with the round thing, the wheel thing, the lock on the top of it. Nice to get that container set in just a plain black color. And the Joker Mobile has the chain on the back of it, and then, you know, you got the hook, so you hook onto that and you pull it out. This would be a print. That's nice. Comes with money. I think plenty of people will appreciate that. This is just a missile. It could be used potentially by either, but I don't know. Was there a place for that to connect? Where would that go? I guess, okay, so he just holds on to it. So I guess the intent is for him to use it as a rocket launcher. He would hold on to it and use it as a rocket launcher, and then you just take the whole thing out of his hand and then, you know, make it go along, which is a lot better than having just a small thing at the end of a launcher. I think this makes more sense to kids, and obviously it makes more sense in the comic universe where you're making everything extra large and a little bit on the silly side. So I think that works out. He also has a crowbar. So Batman here is a basic black Batman with the red trim. Does not have a separate belt piece. I think that's fine. I think this Batman is successful. The Joker is okay. This is not my favorite Joker. It doesn't have the most, it is pretty colorful, but it just doesn't stand out that much to me. What is it? I don't know if there's anything that's really missing here. I personally wish that there was something more there. It feels like there's something just a little bit lacking about that. Is it just me? It might just be me, but I have to think about that a little bit more. Let me know what you think about that, though. And then this is Batgirl. She comes with a skateboard, full-length legs, so, you know, articulatable, grappling gun. You have to use your imagination once again, but I'm assuming there's going to be a secondary face under there. Did we see that in a different picture? That's the same one. Oh, yeah, there we go. A more serious one. That's good. Yeah, that's very good. Did we see alternate face? So a happy face for Batman, regular face. Okay, there's the alternate face for the Joker. That works. Yeah, I mean, look at how simple that Batmobile is. You know, it's basic build, and then there's other stuff that's added on top of it. But I think that is good. I think I have one more picture of this as well. Oh, yeah, a lifestyle picture. This is what it really looks like. Okay, so I do not like how much ground clearance there is. I don't like the look of how much ground clearance there is underneath the Batmobile. But that does give enough clearance for these side launchers to fold down. One good thing about this, for the sake of play, combined with the ground clearance, is the use of semi-pneumatic tires. You know, those have a little bit of squish to them, and that means that this can play easily on carpet, even if it's probably medium pile carpet. However, the Jokermobile definitely cannot, because that thing is slammed. It is one single plate off the ground, and the corners, those corners right there and right there, can get caught on even low pile carpeting. So a little bit of a miss on the playability with that, compromising more in the direction of good looks. I really like the looks of it, but I do think that it would play better if they had raised this up by at least one plate. I think it would be a better toy if it was raised up, even though it wouldn't look as good to me personally. Do I have anything else? Nope, that's it. So that's those. I'm really happy with this set, even though it's a junior set. I think it's really, really good for what it is. We'll have to see what the price ends up being. If I were to guess, so I would want this to be $20. I would expect it to be $25. Being juniors, I mean, you got to think about the juniors tax. The 4+ sets always tend to be extra expensive. They have the bigger pieces. Maybe 30. That feels like a stretch to me. I would give it $25 on value, but I'll have to see how that works out. And then this, given that it includes the stand, I think this is the better picture to look at for that. Includes the stand, this opens up. Only two figures, though. I feel like using only two figures and not having Robin be included there, I feel like probably the designer was required to have Conflict in a box. They probably wanted to have Robin in here as well, but they weren't able to get budget for it. So I feel like this is pushing the limits of its budget, which means that I think it won't be as expensive as it looks like it should be. I'm trying to figure it out in my head. This is a 8 wide. This is an 8 wide car. It's pretty sizable. I'm going to say they would want to sell this for $35 or so, and they're actually going to sell it between $25 and $30. It's not going to be $20. If it's $20, that would be amazing. That would be great. I want to say $25. Just guesses here. Maybe the information is already out. I haven't seen it. I looked for it. I wasn't able to see actual numbers, but yeah. I've taken a look at these. I've given you my thoughts about them. Let me know what you think, though, down in the comments. And, you know, definitely this is not good. They should not have made that look like it actually lights up to that degree. That's a little bit too much. It's a little bit deceptive. But yeah, let me know what you think about these, and we will see the full official, full resolution pictures come out hopefully very, very soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.